Yeah, we were forced to go to McDonald's to get a little something to eat. It's like 2 o'clock. Going to McDonald's, it's only slightly better than going to Walmart. But sometimes you just have to do what you have to do to survive.
We're a couple days too late.
Veterans Day was Friday and today's Sunday, but we're out here near Hawthorne, Nevada on the Veterans Memorial Highway, also known as US 95. I came out to Hawthorne today, or we came out to Hawthorne today, because I was on the internet, we were looking for something to do, and I read about the Walker Lake conspiracy. I didn't know what that was either, but apparently here at Walker Lake, some people believe it's a secret U.S. Navy submarine base. Yeah, I don't get that either. But anyway, we're on the far side of Hawthorne, south of Hawthorne, about 5 miles. We're going to we're going to head back into town. We're going to stop by the place where they think there's a base or a submarine base or whatever. And then we're going to look at Walker Lake and whatever. But we stopped here on the side of the highway because of these big trucks.
Get a look at those trucks. Oh, those are cool looking, aren't they? It's like my inner 8-year-old is coming out. Look how big they are compared to the Jeep.
So anyway, you can see, I'll zoom in. I'm using the iPhone because I forgot the memory card for my other camera. I'm an idiot. Anyway, there you're looking at some of the bunkers out here in Hawthorne. We'll stop down the highway a little further and see some better ones. Apologize for the traffic noise, but anyway, there's some of the ammo bunkers. Hawthorne is an ammunition depot, and they keep the ammunition in bunkers such as the one you see there. Basically, so you know, if it explodes, it doesn't, you know, cause a lot of damage. Up on the hill there, you can probably hopefully see the bunkers. There's literally hundreds, maybe thousands of those bunkers dotting the hillsides around here. And in fact, here's some others. I'm sure you can see these. There's some others. They basically the dirt mounds inside, they have some kind of storage area. And in case, you know, some of the ammunition explodes, they will contain it and it won't spread to all the other ammunition, which I guess makes sense. So anyway, that's where we're here today. We're gonna go check out the secret submarine base conspiracy and see if there's any validity. There's not. But anyway, that's why we're here. So anyway, we're gonna take some more pictures of the bunkers, but then we read the signs that got plastered all over the fence, and they specifically say no photography. I'm pretty sure they're not going to arrest me or throw me in jail, but I figured I'd follow the rules. So that's the only look you're going to get at the bunkers. Look them up online. They're all over. But anyway, we're going to head into Hawthorne. We're going to stop by the, whatever it is, the Ordnance Weapon Museum or something. I don't know if it's even open, but
it didn't look open.
There's a tank and all kinds of bombs and stuff out there. So we're going to go check that out. So anyway, that's it. You don't get to look at the bunkers. If you want, you have to drive to Hawthorne, Nevada. And if you do, that's your problem, not ours. So. Now we're in Hawthorne proper. There's not much here, but we're in the little park, like some kind of Veterans Memorial Park, something like that. I don't know what it is. I should have looked at the sign. But anyway, there's a big anti-aircraft gun. Hawthorne is Well, it's a military town. It's dominated by the army base, which, you know, has all the spittings and ordnance storage base, really. There's some other stuff they do here, but in any case, you know, it's pretty much a military town, so they're very, see, like they have the exceptionally large flag, and they have these everywhere. I'm sorry, that's not exposed very well. There we go. Memorials. Those who fought in wars, I believe, were from Hawthorne. I'm guessing. Doesn't say that, but I'm assuming. And like I said earlier, the highway out here is named the Veterans Memorial Highway. Oh, here's some more. Oh wait, what's this? I'll just walk by this. The Marines of the 2nd Marine Expeditionary Force, March 18th, 2013. Semper Fi. And then over here, more World War II, Vietnam War, and law enforcement firefighters. Memorial. I gotta go back to this other one. I remember what this is. Hold on, there's another rock. Oh, World War I is over here. There's World War I. Oh, it is Veterans Memorial Park. See? So, I'll talk about this plaque real quick. I remember what this was. Back in 2013, there was a training accident. They were, the Marines listed here were training with mortars, and something happened, and they were killed here in Hawthorne. I remember that now that I read this, so take that for what it is. It's a sad event, especially they were just training, but that's what happens. That's why we honor the men and women in the military, because even when they're not fighting wars, they do tend to live a more dangerous existence than most of us. So anyway, rest in peace, guys. Over here, there's the big Hawthorne sign, in case you forget where you're at. But over here, there are some, I don't know what you call it, some art. You can see them. They look like flowers, but they're not. They're bombs. It's like a tulip, a daisy, and whatever that is. And they're all made of bombs. That's Hawthorne. Everything's made of bombs in Hawthorne. It's strange. Then we got this really cool looking Hawthorne sign. Neon. I bet that looks cool at night. Too bad I'm not here at night. Let's see what it says. The Pillar of Light. Dedicated in later forces of the Hawthorne Club. So this is an old sign. Hawthorne Club was demolished. So. And then over here, just to prove everything is made of bombs, that's a cemetery, and the that's a cemetery. Oh, okay, well, I'm waiting for cars to go away. They're not going to go away. Anyway, just prove everything is made of bombs. Across the highway there is a cemetery, and out in front is some kind of memorial, and it's surrounded by bombs. Everything. See that McDonald's over there? It's made of bombs. It's not made of bombs. I could. There's jokes there, and I'm not gonna make them. That rock, that memorial, on that big slab of granite there, is taller than I am. So probably maybe 8 feet tall. So you can get a sense of the scale of that. What is that, 100, 120 feet tall? The flag hangs halfway down. The flag is absolutely massive. So this flag was flown over the U.S. Capitol in Washington, March 18th, 2013. This is the flag that was flown in honor of the Marines that died in the training accident from the other memorial. So I remember that. That was national news. It was a tragedy. Like I said, you know, they were just training and ended up giving their lives. So sad, but that is life in the military sometimes. Check this thing out. This is an old, I'm guessing an anti-aircraft gun. Maybe, I don't know, it could be just regular gun. I don't know. I don't really know, but look, you can get up on it. Look, it's triggers. Look at that. It's pretty cool. I wonder if it works. I don't know, I gotta climb up here now. I don't think it works. It's too bad. We could attack Fallon. Let's see. All right, so I was filming and I had the camera at a different angle and the sun was over my shoulder and it was totally washed out. And then I filmed again and didn't actually hit the record button. So here I am again. I'm sitting in the gun. There's a seat on this side. So there's obviously something off a ship, being it's painted gray and it swivels and does all kinds of fun stuff. Doesn't look like it's meant for land warfare. But it's very small, very tight. People in World War II must have been much, much smaller than I am. Everyone was like 5'7" and weighed like 135 pounds soaking wet. So I guess what happens when you live through a depression. But anyway, I did manage to squeeze in. So, it's not all exciting. If it worked, but it doesn't, so. All right, we're at the, what is that place? I don't know. It's like the Ordnance Museum or something. Anyway, you see they have bombs, like this undersea mine. And there's some missiles over there. Or whatever. I don't know what they're called, missiles, rockets. Cases for torpedoes. This, the nuclear bomb. I don't know if that's true. I don't know what it is. Some kind of bomb. Training mine. It's another mine. They like mines. There's another undersea mine. That's an MK-51 mine as opposed to the MK-30 mine we saw earlier. Another torpedo of sorts. More torpedoes, and bombs, and mines, and oh, and the tank. Yes, there's a tank. I know you can't see it because the sun's behind it, but whatever. Ooh, looks, I can climb on this at my own risk. I'm good for taking risks. Oh, I can't get in it though. Yeah, it's an old, I believe this is a Patton tank. Post World War II era. It's cool. Let's go over to the sunny side of the tank. Oh, there we go. Much better. There's the tank in all of its glory. Said, I believe he. Oh, it even says around that. An M47 Patton. Strangely enough, here's a piece of movie trivia. In the movie Patton, they used these tanks, named after Patton, instead of Sherman tanks, which would have been more accurate. More bombs, shells, the USS Alabama, which is really just a torpedo. The inside. Oh, what is that? I think they're closed today. There's the Navy something. I don't know if you can see that, but I don't know. Oh, it's a helicopter of some sort. I don't know if you can see that, but there you go. Lots of bombs. Missiles and shells. All kinds of different stuff.
Is that supposed to be
the Oh, look,
Navy?
A Jeep. A Jeep. More bombs. some kind of cannon. I don't know. Howitzer? Something? I don't know. I don't think it's a howitzer or not. Very cool though. So, looks like there was more than one training accident here in Hawthorne. Besides the one in 2013. Here we go. Oh, here's a, this is a 45-inch or 16-inch gun barrel. 1940. This probably came off a battleship. You can see, if I can see the rifling in there. A couple of deck guns off a ship. Don't know what they are, doesn't say. You can see they're shells. I assume that's what those are. More bomb cart crossings, yes, bombs.
Yes.
And here's one of our robot overlords. As you can see, part of the reason we're going there is the Naval Undersea Warfare Center Detachment. This is where our conspiracy theory comes in. I can't take pictures of the sign because it says no pictures, the real sign, but there's actually this exists out here. I assume it's practice for mines and dropping bombs and ordnance and stuff. We did once see what we thought was a Navy SEAL or something, an operator in the McDonald's after one of our kids' basketball games. So I'm thinking maybe those kind of guys come here and train, but anyway, some people believe that there's submarines in Walker Lake. We're gonna go over to Walker Lake and see if we can see any submarines. I don't think we will, but we'll find out. On here, you ever wonder what a bunker buster bomb looked like? That's it. Here we are on the cliffs above Walker Lake. It's very, very steep right here. Look, you can see the sun just went behind them. It's so pretty.
So this is Walker Lake. Sorry, there's a highway right behind me. So you can hear the traffic. It's pretty calm today. Not quite mirror quality calm, but pretty calm. Dan told me I'm supposed to look for submarines while I'm out here doing this. I'm pretty certain I'm not going to find any submarines.
So we've been out of here for a little while, looking for submarines. We have yet to see one. No periscopes, no conning towers, nothing. No big cool explosions underwater, like when a missile or a torpedo hits, nothing. No submarines. So I'm calling this one debunked.
Or what did they say?
Busted, maybe. I'm pretty sure there is no secret submarine base in Hawthorne, Nevada. There is no tunnel underneath the California heading to the sea to get them here. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's not the case. Anyway, that's our video. Thank you for watching. We really appreciate it. And we will see you next time, whenever that is.
Say anything?
Yeah, say goodbye.
Oh, goodbye. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.
There's another thing I've driven by about a million times that I've never actually stopped to look at or do. I've always wanted to put my Jeep in that tunnel. I think it's part of the old highway. It's not big enough to be a train tunnel. Anyway, I'm putting it through it.
All right, I did it. I put my Jeep in the tunnel. You can see it's kind of tight.
Hunter will explore this extremely boring tunnel.
There's no bats. There's no turns or twists or anything. Oh, let's see. I don't like that. Woo! It's so bright out there. So, anyway, here it is. The tunnel. I don't know. You can imagine if this was the old highway, because there's an old roadbed you can see paralleling the highway. And so I'm guessing this was for cars, like the old road. Imagine driving through this every day. I know my Jeep's taller probably than a Model T or a Model A, but it's probably not much bigger overall. And it barely fits in there. So well, my old Dodge pickup, I don't think I could even tang it through there if I would have hit. It's cool though. Woo! Alright, I did it.
It's very scary. Look at those rocks. They're just barely hanging there. Can we maybe like...
Yeah, look, we're right under that rock. It's like a Roadrunner cartoon.
Yeah.
Let's see what that really looks like. Oh yeah, that does. That looks like it's going to chip off.
Yeah. It's,
any
it's,
moment. I should yell. Ah! Nope, didn't come down. Huh. I'm glad I didn't go that way. We were going to try and go around the side of it and come in this way, but I could have done that, but it's not the kind of thing I'd want to do without all by myself. That's a nice little rock garden over there, so not to mention this 4-foot-tall step here. Okay, we drove through the tunnel. Bucket list item checked off. It's not really in my bucket list, but it's still something I always want to do. We followed the road through the tunnel and couldn't find a spot to get back up on the road because it's lined with guardrail and it's on a big embankment. So we have to go through the tunnel again.